In this guide, I'll be showing you how to make still images come to life with 3D camera and take your shots using the perspective of a real camera for any editing software. This guide is not for those who already use Adobe Premiere or professional tools that already have this feature, but rather for amateur users like me who use CapCut, Filmora, or other beginner tools. The idea is not to learn how to use Pro Tools, but just what we need to make this effect and import it back to our favorite tool. Where do we do that? DaVinci. Free to download. Let's do this. So, once you get into DaVinci, the interface might look a bit scary, but don't worry. We'll only be looking at what's necessary. Go directly to the media box and import your media with a right click. I have here a couple of transparent images with the ocean, people, and a tent. You can get these from any site and remove the backgrounds. This interface has many tabs, but we'll only be using the Edit or Cut tab and Fusion tab. Drag your images and place them on the timeline. The top layers will be the images in the background. On the right panel, you have these commands to scale up and down your images and move them left and right. Just drag the mouse left and right when you're on them. And place your objects according to the final scene. This does not need to be precise. Once you're done, select all your assets, right-click, and create a new Fusion clip. Fusion clip, not compound clip. Then head to the Fusion tab at the bottom part of the window. Here you have these boxes. This is very important. This might scare you off, but don't worry. Just follow exactly these steps. These little dots allow you to display the element on one of the view windows. Start by removing these merge boxes that were automatically created. Identify each asset and rename it accordingly by pressing F2. This will make it easier for the next steps. And place an image plane for each of your images. It's this little button right here. That will make a 3D version of your image. Do this for all your images. Then, using the keys Shift and Space, look for the Merge 3D tool and add it. And connect all your image planes to that. And now all our images are merged into the same scene. Then press Shift and Space again, and look for Render 3D, and connect the merge to that. And connect the render box to the Media Output box. Finally, look for the 3D camera, and link it to the merge box. And it will always be this way. Image planes, merge 3D, render 3D, and 3D camera. And now, you can use the three arrows on the camera to move it on the X, Y, and Z axis. Use the wheel button to move the space, and hold Alt and Wheel Mouse to rotate your point of view. What you need to do now is space all the images from each other. Select them from the boxes, now the names come in handy, and use the blue arrow to push them away from the camera. And you will need to scale up the images in the back so that they always fill the view. To do that, select the corresponding box and go to the Transform tab on the right. And use this cursor. And you test, go back and forth with your camera, and make sure everything is at its place. Now some basic commands for the camera. You use the three arrows to move it on each axis. On the right panel, you have some controls to rotate the view of the camera along these axes. Just drag the mouse left and right. And now the movement. You go to the beginning of the timeline and click the Transform tab. And on these diamonds to activate the keyframes. Oh, and you might find that the camera is no longer displayed. Just go to the box map and activate the little dot on the merge box. And place the camera to the starting position. Then go back to the timeline and move it towards the end. Go back to the Fusion tab and replace the camera in the end position. Now we see these keyframe curves on the spline window. If you don't see the window, right-click on the camera and select Edit Spline. And just create curves on every keyframe, using this little button on the bottom left. That will make the camera movement smoother. After you test and adjust, go to File then Quick Export. And you have your clip that you can import on your favorite editing tool. And continue your editing. Let's try another example, and use a different camera movement. I have this urban art that I got from a vector, and split into multiple layers. I import all of that, as we did previously, place everything, and create a fusion clip. Same operation as before. Create the image planes, merge box, render box, and connect the 3D camera. It will become easy once you do it a couple of times, and you space your images from each other just a tiny bit. For the camera, on top of moving it on the axis, you can also rotate it. Drag your mouse left and right to make it rotate the way you want. You also have this cursor to increase or decrease the field of view of your camera. So let's try something. We go to the beginning of the timeline and adjust our camera in a perspective way, from the left. Use all those transformation commands to adjust the camera like we want. And we do the same thing for the end keyframe. You have this red line that shows you the path of the camera. And like we did previously, we go to edit the splines. Just select everything with the mouse and click on the curve button to make all movements smoother. Let's now try to abuse the 3D rotation. I got this Superman here, just a plain image with a removed background. And this time, let's try to use extreme camera angles. So by now you know the drill, which has become easy, I suppose. Insert an image plane for each, connect to a merge box, connect to a render box, and bring in a 3D camera to connect to the merge box. Space out the images from each other to create that cool parallax effect. And bring in your camera to the initial scene. Bend it, rotate it, do as you wish. In this example, I'm just trying to take shots that are angled. And I use for this example 4 keyframes, dispatched on the timeline. All you need to do is make sure your character stays in the camera view and that the background is at the right scale. And when you're done, you export as usual. Another thing I should mention is that you might want to add your own green screen, if you want just the character. Nothing easier. Bring in a green screen and drag it to replace your old background, and re-export your clip. Now, you can bring in whatever background you want afterwards. You'll find it under chroma key in most editing tools, including CapCut. As a matter of fact, you can do it with any color, not just the green. As long as the color in the background is not present on your main character. And you can bring in any background you want, including a video. Also, you can play with the speed of the clips to spice it up a little. You have these pre-made speed curves, or you can make your own. And these speed curves can really bring spice to your clip. I invite you to check out a tutorial I made on those speed curves for CapCut, if you haven't yet. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, leave us a comment down below. Until next time, cheers!